Hey everybody, I'm Chanel Herlin and you are watching the New Music Buzz. We are on the black carpet for the movie premiere of The Space Between Us. On today's show in our artist spotlight, we have rising country star Luke Wade, and already 2017 has given us some juicy gossip, so we have Maddie with some pop topics. So with all that said, let's start the show. Hey everybody, we are here on the black carpet at the Arclight Cinema in Hollywood, California for the movie premiere of The Space Between Us, starring Gary Oldman, Asa Butterfield, Carla Gugino and Britt Robertson. The black carpet is just about to start, so let's check it out. Okay, so congratulations on your film. This is really looks like such a beautiful love story. Can you tell us about your character?
My character, Gardner, is the first human born on Mars, and he comes to Earth to find out where he is and where he belongs and what it means to be human and to find his dad and connect with people because he's been so detached from the real world.
Have you ever done a long-distance relationship yourself, being from the other side of the world?
Not really. Okay. Never for any amount of time. Yeah. No.
And if you had to go to Mars, have you actually ever wanted to go to Mars? Because I know some people are like, hell no, I don't want to go to Mars. And other people are like, yes, take me to Mars.
I wouldn't go to Mars. I would love to go to space, but Mars is just a few thousand miles too far. Yeah.
And so when you were reading this script, what drew you to the character and drew you to say, yes, I'm going to take on this film?
I think he's a very original character and he's interesting, and I knew I'd be able to have a lot of fun and creativity bringing him to life. And ultimately, having fun is the most important thing. You want to enjoy what you do. And the story as well was just very sweet and interesting, and it's combined so many different genres. I just thought it was a great piece of writing.
Tell me about your character. This is such a beautiful love story. I can't wait to hear about your character.
She's a cool girl. She's a little bit of, she's kind of tough. She's a little rough around the edges. She doesn't really know much about life other than how to just, survive. She comes from foster care, so she's like struggling a bit. But then she meets Gardner, and he sort of softens her. And they go on this journey to figure out what's going on in his world, who his family is. And then they sort of realize that like they're each other's family.
And when you were presented this script and you read it for the first time, what made you say, yes, I want to be in The Space Between Us?
I liked that it was a challenge. Like, it was, really ambitious script. It's a lot of genres. It's, a lot going on. And so it seemed like Tulsa was a really cool role. Like, I enjoyed playing the juxtaposition of where she starts and where she goes and her relationship with Gardner. There's a lot that I liked about it.
I play an astronaut named Kendra who has been sent up to Mars. She thinks to terraform Mars, but it's ultimately to actually watch over Gardner. And she's really there to kind of monitor him and make sure he's safe, but she ultimately starts to care for him deeply and sees that he's having this sort of online situation with this girl that he's falling in love with. And though I'm supposed to be forbidding that, I feel like I can't let it go. And ultimately, she becomes his biggest champion for getting to Earth and seeing the person that he loves.
And when you were reading this script and going through the story, what drew you to say, yes, let me do this film?
You know, it was really quick with this one. I read it. I thought it was such a beautiful story. I'm a huge fan of Gary Oldman's. I love Peter Chelsom, our director. And I thought this was just a really interesting woman who was running away from life in a way and using her profession as an excuse on some level. And though it's a very noble profession, I think anytime you close a door and aren't willing to look at something, it's going to open again. And in that case, she ends up going back to Earth and to the messiness of Earth that she ran away from. And it ends up being a really full circle experience for her, too. And I thought that was a really interesting character.
Beautiful, beautiful. And this is a long-distance relationship as well that happens in the film. Have you ever had a long-distance relationship before?
Not as long-distance as this. Not Mars to Earth, but I have. I have, and they're tricky.
Yeah.
They're always, as we know, they are very hard. But love does conquer most things, so... Yeah.
And last question, if you had to go to Mars, what is the one thing that you would take with you?
Chocolate.
Next up, we have Maddie with some pop topics after these messages.
With Chanel on the Space Between Us carpet, but first, Ariana Grande is apparently the hardest working human on the planet. We have some highlights from the People's Choice Awards, and Vanessa Hudgens is powerless in her new TV series, and it's all coming up right now on Pop Topics.
I don't need permission, made my decision to test my limits, cause it's my business, God is my witness.
Apparently, no other 23-year-old works as hard as pop star Ariana Grande. So she claims. The other day, the singer posted this adorable picture of her on a sidewalk to Instagram. However, she's been feeling the heat from fans all over social media from the caption she put saying, "When you're cute, but you're also the hardest working 23-year-old human being on earth." Fans immediately caught on to the one-sided statement, and it didn't take long for them to take offense to Ariana's definition of hardworking. Many people called her out for forgetting the young people who need to work multiple jobs in order to make ends meet. Another majority mentioned are veterans, police, doctors, etc., who don't get to sing for their careers. Even after the post backlash on Ariana Grande, she still continued to keep the post and caption up on Instagram. As of now, she seems unfazed by the hate, but fans are still seeking an apology from her misconception. Whether we get an apology from Ariana or not, it seems like she's still kind of out of touch from reality. The People's Choice Awards took place this past Wednesday night, and harmonizers were on the edge of their seats anticipating Fifth Harmony's performance. The group rocked the stage playing their hit song Work From Home during their first performance without former member Camila Cabello. Although Camila originally sings the first verse on the track, the group band together as one to sing her part. On top of that, they took home their own PCA for winning the award for Favorite Music Group. Although Camila is missed from the group by fans, it's no doubt to anyone that the remaining girls gave it all they got. Fans tweeted their support for Fifth Harmony, but their anticipated performance was not the only thing that people were talking about.
Kevin Hart received an award for Best Comedy Actor in a Movie, and during his acceptance speech, he thanked his co-stars for making him the actor he is today, and playfully left out The Rock, in which cameras inadvertently caught him giving Kevin the finger.
Last but not least, man, all of the co-stars that I've had in my life that have helped me grow in this business, I appreciate you all, man. You know, I'm definitely able to do what I do because of the help that I've had on camera. So this one goes to all of the co-stars that I've had except The Rock, because he hasn't helped me. He hasn't helped me at all. You've actually lessened my talent. It's went down since you've been in my life. Thank you guys so much. I love y'all. Peace.
I'm sure it was no ill intent for the playful gesture, and we can't wait to see these two on the big screen later this year. And finally, Chanel got the chance to talk to Vanessa Hudgens, who will star on the new NBC comedy called Powerless. She talks about her character on the show and the possibility of having superpowers of her own. Let's take a look.
I play a character named Emily Locke. She's at a very pivotal point in her life. She decides to nix her own job, her old job, because she wants to make a change and help people.
Yes.
And gets a job at Wayne Securities, where she is the director of research and development.
Yes.
And what they do is they make products for people who don't have powers to be able to survive in a world of superheroes and supervillains.
Yeah, it sounds fantastic. And if you were a superhero, what superpower would you like to have?
I mean, I want to be able to teleport.
Okay.
But I think I would do it like in a butterfly costume.
Oh, yeah.
And I would have like amazing, beautiful wings. Long wings,
beautiful,
and like
colors.
Have long hair.
Oh,
and like a bedazzled bodysuit. I would just be very fabulous.
Well, you could totally work it, and you could totally be fabulous. And you know, you've done so many films, but now you're going into TV series. Is this something that you'd like to continue doing?
I mean, I never really thought I was going to be doing TV, but then they brought me this concept for the show, and I love, like, The Office and Parks and Recreation, and NBC did both of those, so I found out they were doing a half-hour workspace comedy for NBC. I was like, oh my gosh, that'll be so cool. And there's CC Comics involved, like, that's the backdrop. I was like, this is going to be something really original, which I think is really fun.
For more information, go to www.thenewmusicbuzz.com. Let us know what you guys think in the comments below, or follow me at @Maddie_Makely. Thank you guys so much, and I'll see you next time.
Zero gravity. It's uncharted territory.
Sir. We lost her.
The heart will simply not have the strength in the Earth's gravity. Bones will be brittle.
He wouldn't even survive the trip back to Earth.
So the child remains classified on Mars?
Yes.
Gardner is the 16-year-old boy. He's met less than 15 people in his life.
What if no one knows I exist? I'm raised by scientists.
He knows about Earth.
Hey, Tulsa.
I'm out of here the second I turn 18.
I just wish I could go with you.
And he knows it's all happening without him.
Bring him home.
How am I supposed to act with the people?
Talking in T-minus 1 minute.
So many questions about Mars.
Not as many as I have about Earth.
This is a story about coming from Mars to Earth, not from Earth to Mars,
yeah.
And finding true love and going on a road trip to find his father. And it's a great story. I mean, it's a great... If I was to tell you that, you'd say, yeah, that sounds like a good idea, right?
So. Well, like you said at the end, you were a little bit teary-eyed. Have either of you ever done a long-distance relationship and could relate to these kind of characters?
I have not.
Oh, okay.
No.
Oh, that's lucky.
I dated a Martian once.
Oh, how was that for you?
You'll have to find out. No.
Okay, and last question. If you had to go to Mars, what is the one thing that you would take with you besides oxygen?
Oh, that's good. Well, I'd probably... a lot of water.
Water?
Yeah.
Nice.
Yeah.
You need water to survive.
A few friends, I think. I wouldn't want to be up there on my own. So.
Yeah, you know, as a composer, you're always looking to the film to try to find a direction for the score. And in this case, you know, the director, Peter Chelsom, said to me, you know, we've got this character and everything on Earth is new to him. Caterpillars, rain, everything is amazing. And I thought, you know, how can we look at Earth and instruments, musical instruments, that way? So we sort of set out on a path of trying to find music in everyday things that we otherwise would have overlooked. Even junk, old instruments, old metals, you know, everything. And it really flavored the score that way.
Wow, how much of a challenge was that for you? Were you able to put things together quite easily, or did it take quite a few times before it actually started to sound good?
You know, it actually came together pretty easily because I wasn't trying to actually fit these sounds into a pre-existing score. It was starting with those and then built the score around them.
Yay. Oh, that's amazing. And what is your inspiration when you're putting together a song? Where do you draw your inspiration from?
You know, it always has to be in here. It always has to be something you can relate to of the character's journey, or else it's never quite all there. So in this, you know, this film's really about characters trying to find their place in the world, trying to find a place they belong and people they belong with. And I think we can all relate to that. So I definitely drew upon that.
Awesome. Thank you so much for your time. Nice to meet you.
I am Carla Gugino.
My name is Asa Butterfield, and you have just been buzzed.
We'll be back with more Buzz after these messages. After a few years of working in the entertainment industry in Cape Town, South Africa, I decided it was time to make my dreams a reality and move to Hollywood. It was the scariest thing I have ever done. After a few months of trying to find my place in this new environment, hundreds of miles away from home, I am finally in my element. Working as a TV host, I get to interview the coolest people, be on the red carpet, and get to attend amazing events. Don't ever let go of your dreams. In our artist spotlight, we have rising country star Luke Wade, who just released his album Only Ghost. If he looks familiar, you probably recognize him from season 7, The Voice. We talked to Luke about his journey and his new single, 3 Days, in this week's episode of The Climb.
I'm having crazy thoughts. Maybe one woman is more than enough. They're gonna lock me up. My friends don't know me, what I've become. It's been 3 days since I've seen her face. Tell me why her taste is always on my brain.
Well, I got my start. I started writing poems whenever I was 17, around the same time that I started playing guitar. And it was a situation where I had gone through some stuff. Like I'd lost I had an eye injury and became blind in one eye and had a heat stroke and lost some memory and some brain function, actually, and went back to school. And as a kid, it's tough to deal with those kinds of losses. You think that rather than being different or special, like you're just a little bit slower than the person you should be. Like, it's hard to spend things when you're that young because you think that you don't know how to deal with stuff that doesn't go right. And so the way I was dealing was writing, and I needed to take my feelings, my emotions, and bring them to people. And the best way to do that I knew of was music. And so I started writing songs, playing open mics. And then I guess by like 19, I was out playing with my band around Texas. And then, you know, fast forward 13 years, 14 years, however long it's been, and here we are. Yeah, I mean, I've had people, the one thing about Luke Wade is that people have always said that it sounds country, and moving to LA, like, I finally get it. It does kind of sound country. The new single is called 3 Days, and I wrote it with my friend Josiah Lemming here in Los Angeles, and it's just about whenever you get blindsided by the right person and you just can't get them out of your brain, and I think that's one of the it's one of the most beautiful conflicts that you can experience. And I think that songs need conflict, and like, that's my favorite kind, where it's like I love something so much I can't put it down, I can't stop thinking about it, because those are just like the moments that the flowers are blooming and like the sunset, the sunrise, like it's all that kind of feeling, like something's about to happen, something is happening, you know. And so yeah, it's off the new record, and there's a music video you can check out online, and real excited about it. Seems to be doing well. The album came out today. The whole album came out today. It's a more honest experience to who I am as a person. Like the balance between just introspection and also just, I don't know, like, and the zeal I have for life, you know. So I really tried to just forget about everything else and just frame the songs and the vocal. And I wrote a lot more songs for this, so I was able to cull it down to just what I thought are the real, like, were the stars of what I was writing, as opposed to, I don't feel like there's any clunkers on it. Everything serves a purpose and portrays like a real true emotion that I feel. This is the second show of the tour on this record, which is a different band and a different sound. But I can tell you about last night, and it was just really, I've been through so much musically and just on the road, so many ups and downs since the show, since The Voice, that I really just have stopped taking myself too seriously. And it's just, I love interacting with the crowd, being open. Like, if they want to yell something at me, like, that's totally, like, honestly, it's totally cool. Like, come give me a hug. Like, come up on stage. I'll come down to you. Like, it's just, well, I play the songs and I try to frame them, and just, I think of it like a date. Like, I want everyone leaving feeling like they want to go on another musical date with me. Male, female, which I guess that kind of leaves the male out. But it's not, I'm not trying to romance you, but I'm trying to connect with you and make you feel like I really liked sharing this experience with these people that are on stage. And so that's kind of the goal. So take the album when you listen to it, mix it with all that stuff, and yeah, should be pretty close to what's going on. The best way to support is to obviously to come to a show, to buy the album, but also stream it, watch the videos, so that people know that people like, when people go and look at my videos, they can tell like a million people watched it. People care about this guy, and it helps me get booked, and that's just kind of very candid, and it shows me that what I'm doing is working. So spread the word and all that stuff. Yeah. This is Luke Wade, and you've just been buzzed.
NerdFest cash, go to cityloan.com or call 877-553-9071 to borrow $3,000 or more with the equity in your payoff vehicle. Your car is your credit. With City Loan, over 99% of City Loan customers are in good standing every month. So call 877-553-9071 now, and if you sign up for a loan, you're going to receive a free gift card. Don't forget to mention promo code TVAD to receive your gift card, and also don't forget to follow City Loan and Facebook at City Loan Community, and follow us on Twitter at City Loan. Now back to the New Music Bus.
So that's all we have. A special thanks to the staff at NBC, Luke Wade, and to Maddie for helping us with the news. Don't forget to like us on Facebook, Double Tap on Instagram, and follow us on Twitter, all at the New Music Buzz. I'm Chanel Herland. Have a lekker day. For the New Music Buzz.
How are you?
Oh, I'm good. How are all you? Right.
Good, good, good. Probably the only person I should talk to then.
Yeah, we're all about the music. And speaking of music, it's a new year, 2017. What can we expect from you? What's happening with you musically this year?
I just finished a new Bush record 20 minutes ago, Down the Road. Ah. It's a mastering suite. And so this worked out perfect to come to this. But I have to go back tomorrow and do the order, the running order, like sequence it perfectly. The space between, apparently, ironically, for me tonight or tomorrow is about the space between the tracks on my record.
Speaking of space between and going to Mars, what are the three top songs that would be on your playlist if you had to go to Mars?
Oh my goodness. I would probably have something like Most of the Time by Bob Dylan. I would probably have Sarah by Fleetwood Mac. And I would probably have... oh my gosh.
Too many.
God Save the Queen. By the Sex Pistols.
To keep you sane.
Actually, Sid Vicious, My Way.
And just going back in your career, I mean, you've had such an incredible journey. Your music is top notch. When was that moment when you realized, okay, this song is going to make me, this is going to work?
No, at no point ever thought that confidently because I'm English. It's just when I went into CBGB's the first night of our first ever sold out tour where people knew my record, our record from the radio, and it was so packed we couldn't get through the club to play it. Yeah. And so that's everyone, Patti Smith, Television, all the greatest people ever played that club, Iggy Pop. So that was when I knew something was happening.
The New Music Buzz is brought to you by Monster Products, pure Monster quality with Monster sound, and City Loan. Get cash for your car today. And Rockwell Watch's innovative design. For more music entertainment news, go to www.thenewmusicbuzz.com.
Peace out.